Sir, good afternoon to all the delegates. Myself, Dr. Anshna Male, Professor and HOD, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry and Phytochemistry, Nirmala College of Pharmacy, Mangalagiri. I take this opportunity to welcome you all for this national webinar on innovations and applications of data analytics in medicinal chemistry, organized by Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry in collaboration with Elsewhere and Nirmala Innovations and Incubation Center. Before entering into the session, I'm delighted to introduce a few lines about the organizing partners of this webinar. The first one is the Nirmala College of Pharmacy, which was established in the year 2004. It is a self-financed institution affiliated to Acharya Nagarjuna University, Guntur, AP. It is accredited by NAC and recognized by UGC 2-year friend WALBI, approved by AICTE, PCI, and SBTE. It is also approved by Government of Andhra Pradesh. Our college offers various courses in pharmacy, that is diploma in pharmacy, bachelor's in pharmacy, master's in pharmacy with 3 specializations, that is pharmaceutical analysis, pharmaceutics, and pharmacology. Coming to the today's associated partners of the webinar are Elsewhere, which is a Netherlands-based information and analytics company specializing in scientific, technical, and medical content. It is a part of the Relax Group. Elsewhere publishes more than 5 lakh articles annually in 2,500 journals. It archives contain over 70 million documents and 40,000 e-books, and having a total year downloads amount of more than 1 billion. Another partner of this webinar is Nirmala Innovations and Incubation Cell, which is approved by MHRD, New Delhi. It is nurturing the young minds of pharmacy for students and faculty with various research activities like innovations and startups. With this little introduction, I would like to thank the management of Nirmala College of Pharmacy, Reverend Sister K. Maria Sundari Garu, President of Nirmala College of Pharmacy, Mangalagiri, and she is the chief patron of today's webinar. And I would like to thank Sister P. Alfonsa Garu, Secretary and Correspondent, Nirmala College of Pharmacy. She is the patron of today's webinar. And I thank both the sisters for granting the permission to carry out this wonderful webinar session. With this little opportunity, I invite Dr. Sheikh Abdul Rahman Sir, Principal and Professor, Nirmala College of Pharmacy, for sharing his views regarding the webinar on behalf of the management, Nirmala College of Pharmacy. I welcome you, sir, to share your views.
Yeah, thank you, madam. So today I am very much happy that we are organizing 11th national webinar on innovations and applications of data analytics in medicinal chemistry. This program is organizing with the support of a great and an excellent top publisher globally, that is Elsevier. Right, so the key benefits of this webinar is going to get by our delegates to explore the synthesis routes and study of chemical properties, a confident assessment of the compound effects on target protein, quantification of compounds, so we can have the quantification of the products and target affinities. So, and also we can have a rapid assessment of large hits through this, the software which is going to be prepared and developed by Elsevier. And definitely you will be getting a knowledge on retrosynthesis and disconnection approach methods. So these are the key objectives I would like to share all the delegates. And in this regard, my heartfelt thanks and congratulations to the resource person, Dr. Mandar Brass, research consultant, Reaxis Elsevier. I also congratulate Dr. Anjana Male, HOD, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry and Phytochemistry, and their team for effective planning and conduct of this webinar. My sincere thanks to Dr. Sailendra Kumar Mahanta, Professor and President of our Nirmala Innovation and Incubation Center, for his commitment and dedication towards the carrying out an excellent program with the collaboration of Elsevier. I thank our respected chief patron, Reverend Sister Sundari, and our beloved secretary and correspondents for the acceptance of our request and permission regarding the conduct of today's webinar. I also thank all the delegates of students, research scholars, assistant professors, professors, and principals of various colleges for their registrations for our national webinar. So all the best, and so definitely you are going to get a fruitful deliberations today. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, sir. Now I request that Silent Kumar Mahanta sir to introduce regarding the today's resource person, today's speaker, Dr. Mandar Bodas. So I request Silendra sir, please introduce today's resource person.
Thank you, Dr. Anjana. Thank you, Dr. Anjana. I would like to introduce to all of you our guest speaker for today's occasion, Dr. Mandar Bodas. He is a senior solutions consultant, Elsevier. He is currently the in charge of life science data analytics division of Elsevier. He has worked previously as the senior principal investigator at Biocon, Bristol Myers Squibb Research Center, monitoring the therapeutic areas such as neuroscience, atherosclerosis, heart failure, and fibrosis from 2008 to 2018. He has also served as the research scientist, New Drug Discovery Research Center at Ranbaxy Laboratories, and he looked after the combinatorial library synthesis division and the oncology division. He has completed his postdoctoral research fellowship from University of Montreal in the year 2006 and explored the niche area of solid phase peptide synthesis. He has completed his PhD from National Chemical Laboratory, Pune, in the year 2004, where he developed asymmetric synthetic routes for novel chemical entities. He has received the R&D Milestone Award and R&D Star Award from BMS Biocon Research Center for successful scale-up of BMS 086085 compound. His key research areas include development of novel synthetic routes for chemical compounds, PK/PD profile analysis, asymmetric synthesis, solid phase peptide synthesis, and many more. I request Dr. Mandar Bodas to move ahead with his session and enlighten us with his knowledge. Dr. Mandar.
Thank you very much, Dr. Shailendra, and all the panelists, Dr. Rahman, Dr. Male. So thanks again for giving me the opportunity to present to all of you who are present here. What we will do today is that in terms of the overall presentation, I will divide into two halves. First half, I will give you the details in the slide format, the presentation format, what are the contents, how we have developed this particular tools, the Nutanix tools. And in the next half of our presentation, I will actually take you to the live demo so that you will be able to understand how actually the product works and how everyone who are actually attending this webinar can get benefits out of it, right? So I will just share my slides. And let me know once you see that slide deck.
Yeah, it is visible, sir.
Perfect. Yes. So as the today's session is titled Innovation and Application of Data Analytics, that means that I will be talking about multiple products what we have developed at Elsevier, but I will focus on one such product because as I'm talking to the pharmacy in general and pharmaceutical chemistry in particular, I will like to demonstrate a product which actually will be helpful to the audience catering the pharmacy in general and the pharmaceutical chemistry in particular there. So before I move into my actual topic, I just want to let people know about what Elsevier is all about. So Elsevier actually is falling under RELX group of companies, which has global employees of around 30,000 present in more than 180 plus countries. To develop this kind of tools, we have been partnering with top pharma companies and top universities as well. And we have publishing experience of more than 140 plus years. But over a period of times, we have transformed ourselves from a publisher to more now of knowledge and informatics analytics company there. And our deeper roots of knowledge company has helped us to come up with these innovative tools. So whatever the content we have been receiving as a publisher through our great plethora of journals, and we are one of the largest publishers in the publishing industry there. So what we started doing is that we started curating that particular scientific information, indexing it and making it into a taxonomies to provide maximum discoverabilities. So once we have curated that information, then we started harmonizing that particular content, which actually is segregated into various taxonomies and enabling interoperability within the tools as well. After that, we made it into analytics ready so that the user experience is one of the best for the users who actually utilize this particular tools. Also, they spend as much less time as possible to actually come up with the better results of their searches when they do it through these various data analytics tools. So if you just go through this particular slide, and you as a pharmacy professional or pharmacy students might be aware of the overall drug discovery process, starting from the target finding, validation, till the compound which is launched in the clinic, which actually takes more than 10 to 15 years average to have one compound identified as first the as an investigational new drug, and then as a new drug application, they have to file it before launching the into the clinic. Elsevier actually caters to this complete pharma drug discovery cycle from starting to the end phase with our various products which are developed as a data analytics tools there. So the main platform what I was talking about where the content keeps on coming is the Science Direct, as we are one of the largest publishers. Then we have Scopus, for under which we have 5,000 data from 5,000 publishers there. And through this, we have developed tools, various tools. So for target finding, target validation, we have a tool called Pathway Studio there, which only caters to the target finding and validation stage, where one can even integrate the experiments into the tool there. Then if you talk about the medicinal chemistry part, once you have hit to lead and you have to identify, once you identify lead and you have to optimize the lead, a product called Reaxys and Reaxys medicinal chemistry will be helpful because it caters to the each and every discipline within the pharmacy. And I once come to the product in details in my later part of my slide deck, and even in the demo, you will be able to understand in detail what exactly I am meaning about when it actually caters each and every aspects of the pharmacy. Then we have a product called Pharmapendium. This particular product in combination with Reaxys can be utilized for drug repurposing as well, as it actually has data which gets reported to FDA or the EMA, which is European Drug Authority, the complete data set, which is preclinical to the clinical data set for each and every compound which gets reported to them. So you will have complete PK profile, complete tox profile, complete off-target profiles data. Even we have the DDIs, which is drug-drug interaction models developed within that one, the Pharmapendium tool as well. Again, I will little bit touch base upon that in 2 to 3 slides there, but I will not go much into detail. But if you want to have more info, we can actually get back to that during our Q&A session there. Then we have a product, and again, this Pharmapendium caters from the in the preclinical stage and even the clinical stage, because it has a data coming out of the clinical and the preclinical stage as well. So one can utilize the data coming out of the Pharmapendium. It also has a data of the FDA guidelines, FDA meetings, advisory committee meetings within that, which is again in a searchable form. So one can actually take note of that particular data set and can include that information in their preclinical experiment so that they can actually progress a compound with less attrition and hence save the cost and time. Then we have a product called Embase, which actually again caters to a complete biomedical database there. It is one of the largest biomedical database. Again, I'm not going to talk about it because we are going to focus more on today's topic, which is reaxis and reaxis medchem, which will be useful for the medicinal chemist in general, in particular there. So the MBase, what it does is that it do helps in target finding validation, but at the same time it also helps in the later part of the destructive process, which is again phase 1 to phase 4 trials there, and also post-market data, because a lot of data is captured in the pharmacovigilance space within this MBase tool, which actually also is being used by FDA as well. This tool provides a lot of adverse drug reactions, adverse events, toxicity profiles of the compound which is actually launched in the markets. The clinical key is a completely medical solution there, useful for the doctors there. And Intellect is a tool which actually is in development, which actually has each and everything starting from the target finding validation to the end-to-end process of this one, which is a marketed drug. So because I'm talking to the academicians here, what exactly an academician require or when they face innumerable challenges in their research? They need to generate newer ideas. They need to look for newer collaborations. They need to write grants to get fundings. They need to evaluate their research activities and publish in high quality journals. They also need to steer and plan their research activities with various students under their guidance there. And also on a day-to-day basis, they require to utilize that information what they actually generated through their research experience in their earlier years into their teaching and mentoring processes there. So to address all these various numerous challenges what the researcher R&Ds or the academician face in their day-to-day workspace, we has developed this tool, and that tools actually caters to each and every solutions what these questions have generated for them in their research workflows there. So how this data works in? So if you look at this overall data set, what exactly happens is that there is lot of time and effort which goes into actually acquiring and cleaning and organizing a data. That this is one of the key and important steps in building a various data analytics tools there. If you have a right quality of data, right amount of data, then you can actually get that information in a perfect way, and then you have to do the deduplications, clean and organize the data. So this is one of the unglamorous part of the whole overall process of building a model, a predictive model, you can say, based on the artificial intelligence and machine learning. But once you do that, you can actually have lesser time spent to analyze the model and to have a product which are outcome of that particular process, which actually is tailor-made for the researchers the way you want to develop that one, to allow them to make decisions or give the insights to them. But in overall thing, the main impact happens is the time spent, the costing, the research deduplication, the cost of storage. It takes a lot of amount of research extraction and impact of innovation. So once you have done this, what happens in this particular process is that the main steps are to transform and analyze process there. So this transform and analyze process actually have been divided into 7 steps. So one needs to assign the roles, one need to do the atom mapping. If you're talking about reactions, you have to really do the atom mapping. Then, as I said, you have to deduplicate the data, because if you hit a particular search query and you end up in results with multiple results of the same hit, then you will be actually having a lot of data, but actually that is of no use. So we really need to have the deduplication in set up in the process. Then do the format conversion, class creations, fingerprinting, and rule extractions. So these are the 7 steps which actually takes up efforts to actually help the data scientists transform and analyze data, which actually is taking 50% of the total time spent there to develop these kind of products. So as I have showed in my third slide there, the various product, as I mentioned that time that I will be talking about the pharmapendium space. So this is what pharmapendium is all about. So as I said, it is one of the biggest database which actually carries the information of every compound which gets reported to FDA or EMA, which are the drug authorities in North America and Europe. with the data preclinical and clinical data package, which actually comes as a data package to the which actually is an application package submitted to the FDA's or the EMA's there. As I also mentioned that you can actually take the advantage of this original drug approval documents that are often hard to access, which can be searched within this Pharma Pandya space there. Because they have all the preclinical clinical data asset, you can take the advantage of that information and utilize in your experiments or modify the drawbacks or the first in, whenever you have launched a first in class drug, there certainly will be not the one of the best properties having for that particular drug. So that's why you see a lot of follow-up drugs also, which are actually the best in class, you can say. So for that to have or to do a drug repurposing, you will certainly need those data insights, which actually you can get through the searchable format within the PharmaPendium space. The content, if you talk about PharmaPendium, what it has around more than 4,600 of drug index and fully searchable articles there. We have more than 20 lakhs pharmacokinetic data points, more than 4.5 lakhs of metabolizing enzyme and transport data points, 20 lakhs of safety data points there. And if you see on the right hand side, this is one of the thing which is very hard to find out. And this what helps one to either modify experiments if he or she is willing to actually progress a compound into a clinical candidate, or you help it to make it as a drug repurpose event. So you get a lot of information of FDA approval documents, EMA approval documents, adverse events, reactions, reports, and you have the FDA advisory committee meeting documents. So as a researchers, what questions, what answers you will get to the questions? So when you can actually prioritize drug candidates, one can actually assess small and large molecule drug safety, one can anticipate and mitigate risk, answer which drug candidate to process, you can include or actually refer those experiments, actual experiments, and cite them when you actually make a data package to submit to the FDA as well. You can set efficacy benchmarks for the competition there. One can actually take this as a supporting documents to make a case when they actually file a document to the regulatory authorities. As I already said about this PK parameters, we also have embedded drug-drug interaction models inside then, because as you are, you might be all aware of it, that now there are very few patients who only are on a single drug right now, but there are multiple patients who actually take two or more drugs in a day. And to have those drugs consumed, you certainly have to address the DDIs coming out of this multiple drugs things. So that's the reason we have developed this model, which is again approved by the FDA. And this is available within this PharmaPendium space. Now coming to our database of interest there, which actually caters, as I said, to all the pharmacy subdisciplines within the pharmacy general discipline there. This particular product is called Reaxys. Again, as you might be, if you have heard about it, you might have heard that it is only a chemistry-based solution. But as you see that further, and you actually, once you land up in the live demo there, you will be able to understand more that it is not just the chemistry solution, but it actually is a complete data package there. So it is one of the best-in-class solution with a great user interface there, with the highest number of experimentally validated substance properties and reaction database there. The highlight of this particular product is that it is designed in the way the scientist wants, or the chemist wants, or the pharmacologist wants, or the in vitro biologist wants the tool to actually provide the data set, and not the way we want it to it, because they are developed by the scientists themselves here. So way back in 2000, before 2000s in India, there was neither, if you have heard about our computer tool, SciFinder, there was neither SciFinder or Reaxys in India there. So what elsewhere has done that in 1980s is that there was a database in Germany, which was a Beilstein Commander database of organic chemistry data, and a Gemlin database of inorganic and organic molecular. So they procured these two databases. And as I said earlier, we are one of the largest publishers. So we have our own contents coming out of the elsewhere journals, the books, the patents. And we have now increased our patent space as well. And I will come back to that particular point in just few moments when I talk about the patent space as well. So we have all this data embedded into one tool now, which is actually termed as Reaxys there, which provides answers in a very less period of time and lesser clicks there. If you type reaxis.com on any web browser, be it a mobile browser or a computer browser, you will be end up in the landing page. And I have genuinely copied this or taken a snapshot of this page on earlier date, which is August 23rd, 2020. And why I have taken is that to mention about the updates, you will see now when I go to the tool live, I will come back to this particular slide where you can, if you want, you can remember the number of substances, reactions, documents, and bioactivities captured, which was updated on 23rd August 2020. And we will see how much the data has increased from there to now when I'm talking to you on today's date, which is 7th of May there. Also, this particular tool can be utilized in education. So the institute like yours, who actually addresses the pharmacy students there, they can. This particular tool actually is perfectly catered to the people working in the pharmacy space there. And if you want to know more about it, you can actually type this particular article there in the chemical education, where you will find the information what the author Diamond Ridley provides, that Reaxis is such a tool which actually will be helpful for the educationists as well, the academicians as well. And he is comparing the two differences between two prominent tools, which is SciFinder and Reaxis there. Once, if you talk about the data set we have developed within this tool, we have more than 12 crores of organic, inorganic, organometallic compounds, greater than six data coming out of this, greater than 16,000 journals, chemistry related periodicals, out of which there are 450 core chemistry journals, and out of which we provide experimental data within research sheets from 250 journals and all the patent spaces there. We have more than 5 million of published experimental, so 50 crores data of published experimental facts. More than 5 crores of chemical reactions, experimental procedures. And when you talk about the pharmacy disciplines, we have specific drug discovery and pharmacology journals there. We have medical chemistry articles within it. We have a bioactivity target information data points for which are again searchable in a searchable format there. And to the addition to this literature space, we have data coming out accepted from 105 patent offices and 170 IPC classes. And to name a few, we have data coming out of the US, European, WIPO, Indian patent, Japanese, Chinese, Korean, Taiwanese are the few examples of the patents there. And when you talk about Asian patents, we have actually translated the information in English, such as the experimental procedures, claims, abstract, the front page info, which is the most required information when you as a scientist wants to analyze the patent, because the claims is one of the important fact and experimental procedure. So you can go and execute the reactions, understanding what is claimed and what you actually need to do to come out of those claims. When you want to dig a little bit deeper within this particular tool, we have embedded chemical and physical, chemical, physical, and biosafety data from PubChem within Reaxis made searchable. When you talk about commercial suppliers, we have already now around 300 plus commercial suppliers. And by this year end, we will have more than 700 suppliers data within embedded in Reaxis. So what it will enable you is that you do not go and search multiple vendors, say Sigma, Rich, or other vendors, e-molecules, any other vendors, lab networks, to find out your reagents. But when you are actually searching a reaction, you can actually come to know about the starting materials as well, where you can find out when it will reach you, what is the cost, what is the purity of that particular product. And I will showcase that in my live demo as well. We also have integrated Scopus data, which is again 5,000 publisher data for the citations. And when I talk about the full text, we have full text means we have provided the complete experimental procedures within that. We don't get the full text PDF article with it for that. Then we have embedded Medline and Embase for drug terms there. And we have also embedded Compendex for engineering materials, which actually also help in pharmaceutics as well. When you talk about the pharmacy related data or the medicinal chemistry related data, we provide information on the substances, physical, physical properties. You will be able to understand if your compounds are able to fit in the Weber rule or Lipinski rule of 5. Are they really druggable intermediates there, or do you need to modify which properties of that Lipinski rule of 5 if it is not falling into that one? You will also get information on all the compounds which are reported in the literature regarding the experimental data for in vitro and cell-based data. and also the animal model data. Apart from this, you certainly will get the information on pharmacokinetic, ADME, and toxicity data. Again, this is all searchable format. You can actually do a little bit of structure active relationship for those known compounds there as well. So as a medicinal chemist or as a student of pharmacy, you certainly will like to actually work on a compound which is bioactive target and then develop that particular compound into clinical candidate. Maybe you are in the pharmacognosy, so you will like to search a compound which is isolated from natural product with a particular activity of your choice. Or if you are in the pharmaceutics, you need to develop a particular compound for its formulation so that you actually give that dosage in a particular form which is desired. Maybe it is a oral or subcutaneous or whatever it is. So based on whatever the delivery of that particular drug, you need to design your suitics properties. Or you are in the pharmaceutical industry where you need to design your NCs there. For that, you need to find out a computer intelligence. So we have, as I said, the patent space, increased patent space there to help you to do the novelty searching, improve your computer space. As I said, you have Lipinski rule of 5 for Fiskin's properties, and you have a synthesis planner within ReAccess. So any compound which is known in the literature, which also at least have a one article published for its synthesis precursor, you will certainly find the data within ReAccess for its synthesis as well. Which again, as academicians, you can actually set up projects for your students, master students, research and projects through the synthesis planner as well. When you talk about the pharmaceutical chemistry, you have data about NMR, HPLC, LC, even TLC information within the ReAccess searchable space, which you can take advantage when you do the product analysis there. So when you talk about the competitive intelligence space, you can search the information for a particular target, gene, protein, for a particular technology there. Who else is working on your target or technology there? What are the companies, competitors working on that particular target? And then you can also check the novelty about that particular search. You see if there are no hits, perform a synergy search to find the closest match of the compound, or do a substructure search there. And I will come back to these searches when I go live as well. So in ReAccess, earlier when we were extracting the patents, we only had seven data from seven patent offices there. And it was taking around 20 to 30 days to add data from the patent, accept the data, and make it searchable within ReAccess. But now we have made that process automated. And also, we have decreased the timelines from 20 to 30 days to 4 to 5 days with increase in the data as well from the patent. So we have increased from 7 patent offices to 105 patent offices with 170 IPC classes there. And we have made it searchable. And now it takes maximum of 5 days to get the data from patent and make it searchable within ReAccess there. So if you are either in the pharmaceutical space or agrochemical space or fine chemical space, you will get the required competitive intelligence, competitive information to come out of a particular patent space or make it more novel so that you can actually file a patent of your own there, right? So this will enable you to do a searching for the novelty as well and to develop compounds of your interest which are novel and patentable as well for a particular target. I was talking about suppliers data a couple of slides back there. And to talk about the commercial supply, as I said, we have already integrated data for more than 300 suppliers. But by year end, it's not just 600, but now we have increased that to 700 suppliers there. So you will have a lot of information from the for your starting material, raw materials in this supplier space, which is again in the searchable format. You do not have to go to individual web pages of those particular suppliers to search for your reagents and order it. So you can do it whenever you are doing your reaction search or a structure-based search. When you are actually searching within the tool, we have actually created alerting system for you so that you do not have to search again and again the same particular topic frequently when you want to stay updated with the particular topic of your interest or your subject of your interest. We have created an alert system for you. So if you actually set up an email alert for your searches, which are saved searches in your profile, in the database, you will the ReAccess will shoot you an email notifying you based on your preferences. Like if you have set up a fortnightly updation or a monthly updation or a weekly updation, based on your preferences, And based on the data getting updated, whenever the newer data gets updated, it will shoot you an email notification that, okay, this is your topic of interest and this is a new literature references which have arrived for your particular topic of interest is there. So one need not have to do the searches again and again to stay updated for a topic of your interest or topic or subject of your interest. React is much more tool than a database or analytical tool. It has much more wider applications. You can integrate your in-house data within ReAxis to make it more searchable. And this is advantageous for larger universities or bigger pharma companies there because they have tons of molecules made. They have a lot of chemical reactions done at their end, a lot of intermediates made. So all this data can actually be integrated within ReAxis and made it searchable. Apart from the data, what we carried, what I have showed that, the content we have shared, so that you can actually do not have to reinvent the wheel. If somebody, say, if you talk about Nirma College of Pharmacy and there are five or six professors there, and a particular reaction is done in a particular lab there, which somebody else wants to do in some other professor's lab, he or she again has to do the literature search because he or she is not aware of that particular reaction done in their, your College of Pharmacy, say. So if you actually integrate that particular data within this particular tool, it will be a searchable form and you do not have to check again or do the research. You just hit that search button there and you will come to know that if that reaction has been done or the compound has been made in-house within your institute as well. So we have a professional services team which actually helps the universities or the pharma companies to integrate their content. And I have a slide to show the advantage company. There are many companies who have taken it, but I have an example to show of company AstraZeneca, which actually have been able to speed up the processes and reduce their timelines to achieve a novel candidate, identify a clinical candidate by integrating their in-house content within the ReAxis searchable space. So, In a nutshell there, this particular tool actually provides you answers for your complete research activities in the pharmacy space there. So taking an example of, say, acetyl salicylic acid, you will find around more than 200,000 documents, 200,000 documents within, that's that 22 lakhs documents for aspirin there. What they will give you, you have physical properties which are more than 5,000 exported physical properties for aspirin. You have 1,200 reactions of aspirin. There are 5,000 bioactivity points of aspirin and where you can actually get that aspirin drug, right? So all this information is searchable and available within ReAxis space there. Now, we have talked about till now about data, which actually will help you to understand research, to create research, to write publications, to create reviews article. But finally, you need to go and make that particular compound in a lab so that not just the pharmaceutical chemist who makes the compound, but other people like the pharmacologist, the pharmaceutics, or the guy who actually wants to do pharmaceutical analysis has to utilize his experimental skills to see that the compound acts in vivo, has a good PK profile there, is not metabolizing faster, have a decent profile to progress that into in vivo studies or animal model studies to see if your compound is efficacious there. For that, one needs to make a compound there. And also at the same time, as before our before this presentation, I was discussing with the principal sir regarding the docking and the kind of compounds they have seen good docking scores, which they actually want to make it. For that, you need to really think about your chemistry knowledge on how you are going to make it. But for that, we have actually utilized the artificial intelligence and machine learning tool, the computational techniques, to do the synthesis planning for the researchers there. So when you talk about this drug design, make, test, analyze cycle, which is iterative and you keeps going on and on till you find a compound, which is a compound you can progress to as a clinical candidate, you need to really make that effort in making huge number of compounds, be it in library form or be it in a form which actually will give you more number of molecules, come up with a route which is much more efficient in nature there. So for that, we have collaborated. Again, this is one of the collaborations Elsevier has done. As I was talking on my first slide, that Elsevier do collaborate with multiple pharma companies and universities to develop our tools. So this is one such collaboration which are actually resulted into a product called Reaxys Retrosynthesis there. And Professor Mark Moller, who has his own company as well, named Pending AI. So we have collaborated with that, and due to this partnership, we are able to get this product out, which is a Reaxys predictive retrosynthesis there. And you will see the Nature article there for the molecule getting published. The research work of Professor Waller there, which actually, if you want to go and read out there, you can actually find it in Nature there. So the advantages of this particular tool, that you do not, this tool is non-reliant on extracting and encoding rules by hand. So there were tools in the market, or there are already some tools in the market which actually are designed based on the hand encoded rules. So what happens is that if there are newer reactions, day-to-day reactions coming out in the literature space, they will not be able to modify those tools on a regular basis there, because those rules has to be written by hand and then fitted to the computer to develop those tools. Also, we give the advantage of integrating your own custom building blocks, because you might be a smaller pharmacy college, but there are bigger universities or pharma companies where they have made huge number of intermediates. So you actually can utilize your own intermediates as a starting materials to make novel compounds as well. So you actually can integrate that in our tool. This helps to solve retrosynthesis of twice as many molecules as any competitor tool available in the market there. And is quite 30 times faster than the traditional computer-aided methods available in there. The value it gives, that the experimentation, you will have save time, cost by saving reagent space. You have efficient synthesis there. You can do publications of a known molecule with a different route, or you can make compounds, design your own compounds and publish that as a new compounds with activity as well. This also will help you in teaching, because you can give it to students compound, how a student can come up with a synthesis of a particular compound there, and he and she will be able to understand what possibilities of are available if he or she wants to make that particular compound by various different methods there. So this can be utilized in teaching as well. When you write your project proposals, you will require to make the compound show the synthesis of it. It will certainly help you to provide that protocol on how you are going to target, make those target molecules for which you will actually go and check the bioactivities for. So the advantage what this tool carries is that this tool has been developed on more than 15 million reactions, and out of this, it has also been developed on 100 million negative chemical reactions. So the tool knows that this reaction is going to work and this is not going to work. And that's why the predictions what actually it gives for particular molecules are much more robust in nature. Elsevier has already received the award from GHP International Life Sciences in November 2020 as a best predictive retrosynthesis tool available in the market there. When you want to utilize, as I already touched base upon these points, when you want to utilize this particular tool as a tool for education, grant applications, teaching, getting more publications, and reducing your time and effort and cost to execute the synthesis faster there. So what happens is that whenever a reaction gets published there, it has to be published. You should have at least 3 times that particular reaction reported in various journals. Then only it will be termed as a reaction to be allowed for extracting the rules. So like that, we have 15 million single step reactions, which have been at least repeated 3 times or presented 3 times in various literature spaces there. Then after the reaction gets published, we do the cleaning parts, the SMILES standardization, deduplication, as I told you, removal of non-participating molecules such as solvent, catalyst from there. And then we have to do the atom mapping there. For each carbon atom or of each hetero atom, or the atom gets mapped there. And once the atom mapping has been done, you extract the template to consider to have it as a rule there. So once this rule is formed, then this particular tool knows that whenever the amine gets reacted with acid, it will form amide there. So this is what the rule is all about. The NH2 reacts with the OH of the COOH and to get NHCO bond there. So this rule, the computer knows it. And that's how the rule gets formed from those reactions there. This tool works on the three layers of neural network and Monte Carlo research. So first you have to identify the problem. This is the latest Pfizer molecule for which we have come up with the synthetic route as well through this particular tool there. This is a orally active bioactive molecule which is acting against COVID-19 developed by Pfizer. It is in phase one studies right now. Then you come up with the various, this tool comes up with the various disconnections, say RX, RY, RZ, RW, and to make it decides on, okay, this might be the first break bond or the make bond there, where if you find this particular process for making this, then the other parts of the molecule can be brought into it via the Monte Carlo research. So there are various ways to make these bonds. There are various options there. So it picks up the probabilities with the help of the in-scope filter there to check the feasibility assessment and coming up with the highest probability to make that particular compound with the first step, initiation step there. So once the feasibility requirement with the in-scope filter actually is addressed, then actually the other starting materials, till you reach the commercial available starting material, will be achieved with the help of the Monte Carlo research. And that's how this particular predictive retrosynthesis tool works. So we have, as I said, we have, in a nutshell, we have around 15 million single steps reactions from which we have encoded 4 lakhs rules, which are auto extracted there. And then we apply these three layers of neural networks and Monte Carlo research to come up with a synthetic route there. So we have best-in-class reactions data with extensive commercial substances available there. And as I said, one can also integrate the compounds at their end as well. Then we have the best-in-class deep learning artificial intelligence program algorithm there, which has given up this product, which has excellent user experience. And this has now also been commercialized and people are started subscribing to this particular product, which is called Reaxys Retrosynthesis as well. So the strength is that it can be utilized as an idea generator. It can save a lot of time, cost savings. You can create a lot of publications and patents out of it by utilizing it, because you will be able to come up with new synthetic routes or new compound synthesis through this route. It provides significantly robust suggestions, which we have seen already there. The limitations are that it doesn't provide stereochemistry assignments there, because it's very difficult to come up with the predictions based on the stereochemistry. But if you apply your chemistry knowledge, you can either start from, if you get a racemic synthesis, you can either start from a enantiomerically pure or a diastereomerically pure compound as your starting material, or can introduce the stereochemistry in the molecule based on your chemistry knowledge, based on the same reactions what is published. But instead of that, you utilize a reagent which actually brings in the stereochemistry into the molecule there. It is challenging to get complex natural products stereosynthesis, but it is not the only factor there. There is a solution to it, and we have also worked on it. What kind of various molecules it certainly provides that information, and I have done myself as well. So yes, it might be a limiting factor, but not it is the end of the world. It does provide natural product synthesis as well, but it's challenging. Again, the algorithm doesn't understand between regio and chemo selectivity there. So we are working on that particular limitation right now. And by the next early next year, these things will be addressed automatically. And it doesn't provide routes for the inorganic molecules. This is the molecule on the left-hand side, which I was talking, the Pfizer compound, which actually is a novel antiviral compound in the clinical trials for the SARS-CoV-2. And this is how the routes has been shown. And I have added the which reactions is every step this particular shows. So this is around 6 steps you can get that molecule there. With this is a commercially available starting material. So orange box or a green box will let you know that the particular compound is commercially available. And you, once I will show it to live if you have time there also, and we will come to know from which source or vendor you can actually purchase that. On the right-hand side, this is a molecule from Eli Lilly, which is GLP-1R, GLP molecular agonist there, which decreases oral blood glucose there. And Again, this is a novel molecule which got published in Chemical Engineering News. First time disclosed this structure in the ACA spring meeting, which was held in April 2021. So, and after that, they have published this in Chemical Engineering space. I think 15th April article there. So we have again run up this particular molecule in the retrosynthesis, and it has shown a particular synthetic route, which is again viable route. And it has already links to particular similar reactions, reaxes. So you can actually go ahead and execute those reactions. So this is, you draw a compound, the tool will give you what kind of reagents it has used, how many number of steps are there to make that particular compound. For every steps, you have a confidence score there. And then you can view it as tree view there, where you can see this particular compounds are reaxes example. You click on that particular step to view into reaxes, the similar reactions there, so that you can execute at your end there. So again, this is another way of drawing that particular compound. Again, this particular tool is going to get integrated in reaxes, but it has to be purchased separately. So you draw the compound, you set up various parameters there. So these are various parameters. You can see the diversity of the compound. You can have 20 plants atomate. You can choose your commercial starting materials, which are less than $200 or less than $500, so that you can reduce the cost of your synthesis as well. So once you do that, it compares with, if it is a known compound, then it will compare with the published route versus the predicted route as also. So you will have that, and this will be showing you the complexity of the reaction sequence. This is a quite linear synthesis, and there is no divergent synthesis there, convergent synthesis there. So you will come to know that particular point also. You can view, as I said, you can view the published and predicted route in one view itself. You can check in the cart section where you can procure the starting materials or the commercial, the intermediate there directly. You can check the number of steps there. So this particular route is giving in 7 steps and other routes 4 or 5 steps, whatever it is there. So you can see that particular thing. Then you can actually see the graphical route, as I said. What is this particular, if you click on that, this is the intermediate at this particular steps there in the particular synthesis there. So you can graphically view that particular thing. As I said, we have confidence score. The one is the topmost score, and related to the one, the score is given, and various routes are actually as aligned or according to the score there. The better the score, the first thing it will show in the ranking there. So it is rank ordered based on the score. Then you do not have to navigate between multiple windows. If you see on the top there, there are multiple routes already in as the boxes. So the one you got selected, and for every route, you will have steps already here. So step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, it is already shown. You keep clicking on it, and you will have the related procedures for that particular thing there. Then you can also, no need to navigate between multiple windows. As I said there, you will have literature references at the bottom there showing the procedures there, how you can run that compound. You can export that into my various formats, PDF, doc, XLX, so on and so forth there. What further improvements in this particular thing, what we are doing is that we will be able to bring in the filters to help you reduce cost, increase yield, choose your literature source. We will be adding more flexibility for editing synthesis plan as well. Ability to define, include, or exclude intermediates there, so that, say, you are working on azide intermediate, which actually is sometimes challenging for scale-ups. So if you want to, you can do exclude that particular intermediate and come up with a route by not having that particular intermediate synthesis, you can do that. You can make, you can define your make or break bond disconnection so that you have a route the way you want to design it. So all these things are in the development. This ability to make or break bond will be there, added to the tool in a couple of months itself there. And the tool also will be integrated within the reaxes, as I said there. What we are in a longer format, what developments to the models we are doing, we will be working on the stereochemistry addition there, regioselectivities, supporting tautomers, including more and more building blocks, so that the tool gets more efficient in a longer process there. Coming back to the collaborations there. So if you see here, we have been collaborating with various companies, as I was telling. So these are a few highlights of the companies where they have already, everybody has talked about either they have been able to save a lot of time, cost. So WuXi, Merck, Roche, Lundbeck are the few companies there here. Then this was the AstraZeneca example I was talking about, integration of the in-house data with the Reaxys data, and they were able to save the time to come up with a novel chemical entity as a clinical candidate there. This AI ML technology, artificial intelligence machine learning technology, in collaboration with Janssen Research Group, they were able to come up with more than 163,000 libraries of compound from 12.5 million single step reactions published in Reaxys database. Lapkin's group was able to take the advantage of our algorithms to find 516 molecules that actually might drive waste free economy there. Apart from this, for students, we also have developed in collaboration with Professor Carrero, who is at ETH Zurich, app reaction, name reaction app. You can download it from Google Play or App Store there directly. It provides you more than 875 plus name reactions mechanisms there with peer-reviewed example. You can zoom in, swipe in to learn. So you can learn about reactions on the go, and it will certainly you help the students there. We also give away Reaxys Global PhD prizes there. So for 2021, it was 2020, it was online process there because of the pandemic. And I still we have not opened the 2021 application because the pandemic is ongoing right now. But this is the top three people will get cash prizes. The top 45 finalists actually have flown into an international location, completely paid trip by Elsevier, where they have to present their posters or the presentations to the jury, and from there they will get selected. So once the finalists are selected, the three winners will be actually announced at the banquet closing symposium at an international location, and all the 45 entrants are given opportunity to present their research work, as I said, and they will be provided an access to Reaxys for lifetime, and they will be included into the Reaxys PhD prize club membership, which again is maintained by Elsevier there. So a lot of benefits there. As now I am in touch with your professors here, I will certainly let you know about this when this prize the applications are launched, so that you can actually the students from your institute, if they want, they can apply for this. The students which have finished PhD and within 1 year of your after finishing, they can apply for this particular prize as well. So this ends in my presentation, first the first half of it. And what I will do now is that I will share the web screen to take you to the live tool as well. So if you have questions, do let me know at this moment. If you wish to ask anything, you can type your questions in the Q&A section specifically. Don't put in the chat window there. So start typing your questions, and once I am done with the demo, I will come back to the Q&A section where any of the participants, if they want to ask the questions, they can ask through the Q&A window, or you can raise the hand, and if you are able to see that, we will unmute you to ask the questions orally as well. So I was talking about the Reaxys homepage, and there were 180 million reactions in my screenshot, which I actually had captured in my presentation there, right? So if you see online now, that data has quite significantly improved from 23rd August, which I had showcased in my earlier slide, right? So from there, from 180 million reactions, it has increased to 148 million reactions. Then, substances from 49 million reactions, now it is 54 million reactions. And from 59 million documents, it has increased to 61 million documents. And from 37 million bioactivities, it has increased to 40 million bioactivities. So 3 million data points in a space of, say, 8 months time, which is there. Again, this is this update is not for the Reaxys tool. I am using a different tool. So I will sign out there and check it for the Reaxys. Just a minute. This is a demo tool for the synthesis planner, which I will just change it to it now so that you will see the latest update there. Yeah. So if you see, the update is on the 5th May, which was a couple of days back. Right. So you have you type reaxys.com on any browser, you will end up in this landing page there. There is one question there. Sir, I'm in pharma student. How can I access Reaxys? For accessing Reaxys, you actually have to subscribe to it. So you ask any of your professors to connect with me, and I will again showcase my email address and phone numbers at the end, so that you can write it down, make a note of it, and you can connect with me later on. So you can sign in to this particular tool, create, even though you get access on IP, you can sign into that tool. And then you can actually save a lot of functionalities. So you can actually save your searches in the history. History panel, you go to there, you can save your searches there, as I might have saved something, see. And then you can create email alerts to your searches, which I was talking about. So if you see here, you can set up frequencies of your alerts every month, 2 weeks, weekly, after each update there. What you want to have in your email alerts, you can set up that. And then Reaxys will shoot up an email to you for that particular subject topic or a compound of your interest later on there. You can have your own setup of UI of that as well. Then we have two ways of searching a particular compound there. One, you can actually do it via a text-based search, which works on natural language programming. So if you type three letters of a word, it starts showing you options what you want to search there. So when I'm talking SUZ, it shows me Suzuki, because that is one of the most famous reactions, right? So if I want to run about Suzuki reaction, I just click on it. I look into it. So it provides you information, because it read as a reaction. So it has segregated that reactions separately and the documents related to Suzuki reaction separately there. So if you view into it, even though you might see a lesser number here, if you see here, there are one hit, but there are nine conditions. That means that this reaction is repeated in nine different articles there, the same reaction. And that's why it is for tabulated in the form there directly. So you do not have to worry about the complexity of searching this as a nine times there and then find out, but we have made it in table form. You get the yield of a reaction, you get link to the access to this particular reaction. And if you want exponent procedures, you get directly the exponent procedure within this one, right? So now out of this reactions, if you want to see the best possible reaction conditions to run a Suzuki reactions, you can utilize the yield filter on the left-hand side panel and select say greater than 90% yield. So if you select that, Reaxys will actually come up with the reactions where the yields are greater than 90% there. Again, I am not going into much of details. We already have passed 1 hour there, and I will show the demo for 15-20 more minutes, and we'll go with the Q&A section. And if then interest is there, we'll come back to it, and I can keep showing more and more if based on your interest there. So this is what for reaction is there. I will stop at this moment, and I will go to a structure-based search. So there is a lot to show, but I am not, again, as I said, with the lack of time, I will just show a little bit. And then if we have, we can have one more session there. So in a structure-based search, you have advantage as a chemist. Chemist loves to draw structures in ChemDraw format. So we have embedded ChemDraw within Reaxys itself. Apart from that, we have the Java environment, which is a MarvinJS, which is much more powerful than the ChemDraw tool itself. You can copy paste structures already drawn at your end in ChemDraw, ChemDraw structure, which are either in Word, PowerPoint, or ChemDraw 2 Reaxys, or do vice versa. You can draw here and copy paste in your Word, PowerPoint as well. For that, you need to run this actually application, the clipboard application there. And once you run that, it will convert this icon, gray icon, into green icon. And then you can actually copy paste the structure. The best one is either the MarvinJS tool or the structure to name to structure tool. So as complicated structure like calcitonin, if you type that, you get the structures directly there. So you do not have to draw any complicated structure. You can draw structures by common name, generic name, IUPAC name. So if you have pyrazolo-1,5 pyrimidine as IUPAC name, you draw that, you will have pyrazolo-pyrimidine there. If you type amino acid sequence there, say histidine, alanine, glycine, phenylalanine, whatever amino acid you have, you just type the key letters there of amino acids, and it will draw a sequence for you, for a peptide sequence for you. So this can be easily utilized for that. I will show you a couple of quick tricks what one can actually achieve. Have those from the drawing tools as well. You can actually search if you want to substitutions at a particular position. You can actually say, I want to have substitutions at this particular position and not everywhere. So you can have this as a search tool. And then if you say you want to search a particular, say, group, I'll just go back to here. And say you want to introduce a particular generic group. So you keep typing that, you will have more options coming up there, and say nitro group and expand it. Right. So now it will search para nitrobenzene only. So if let's see, if we do that structure search, you will have substitutions at the para positions only of the nitrobenzene there. And if you see here, now it has done, we can edit the search and actually remove the salts, mixtures, isotopes again. So we'll have a little bit less numbers there. So you have 3 lakhs compounds there, and you know these are the commercial. I was talking about commercial available suppliers. Let's touch base on that as well, of the commercial available suppliers at what information you will get it, and I'll come back to the data again. So you what you get, you can filter this based on the supplier geolocations, usages, packing size, price, purity, stock availability, shipment time, shipment country. So these are multiple options there, and if you see here. Say you want to see supplier informations there, you have when it will reach you. So this was updated on 1 June. The supplier has updated on 1 June 2020, 5 milligram compound of $187. So if you want to have simple compounds there, say you have 100 grams for 40 pounds. This is a request. You can actually request them to have those. So the purity is there. So you can filter based on that. You have all the information there. You do not have to go to each and every supplier to find a particular reagent there. Let's go back to the search results with what they are showing to us. Now you keep seeing this in a grid form. It will be easier to see that. You will see all will be having a para substitutions there. We have expanded that to explicit hydrogen, so you can have a hydrogen simple nitrobenzene as well. But if you see, everything is para because we have selected only a para position search, right? We can do that. Now, if you go to the list search instead of the grid search, just a minute, it's based on my connection, little bit taking time to go back to this one. Yeah, I have done too many clicks, that's why it happened. Okay, so if you want now regarding the data, for simple, say 4-nitrobenzaldehyde, what information you will get? As I was taking you, if you want to check drug likeness of the compound, you can see that if it is fitting in Lipinski rule of 5 or not. So this is a very small compound. Obviously, it will fit in there because the blue triangle belongs to Lipinski rule of 5 or the Weber rule there, where any of these properties, if it is violating your compound line is the orange one. And if it violates a particular property, you will come to know and you can actually modify that particular property of that particular compound to make it more druggable. If you talk about the bioactive data points, you have data, in vitro efficacy data there of simple nitrobenzene as well. So if you see, you have the actual activity there. What is the target it has been again? What is the actual reference there? What is the parameter? And we have converted the actual activity into a PX value, which is a logarithmic scale of the actual value, because the data gets reported into various formats, say micromolar, millimolar, picomolar, PIC50s, binding affinities, constants. So because of that, we have converted that into PX value. So higher the PX number, higher the better the activity of the compound. We have converted that. So if same way, we have animal model data for also nitrobenzene there. 4-nitrobenzaldehyde. So you have the animal model data, which is route of administration, what is the actual value of that one. You have metabolism data coming out of it as well. So you have the target again, what is the actual unit there, and then the safety pharmacology data of any. So for every compound, you will have all these data points there for all the known compounds for which the data is reported in the literature there. Okay, so if you see here, you have all those data points there. Then if you talk about toxicity data also I shown. Yes, if you talk about the spectral data point, physical data points, so you have melting point, boiling point, sublimation, you keep going more and more, and if you'll see all those max information, you will keep having that. Then you have a spectra. So as an education also, if student want to learn a particular thing, he will get all the information related to a particular compound, which is experimental data, which is actually very difficult for him to read out in various textbooks as well. So you will have the actual data points coming up there. For NMR spectroscopy, we have started adding the text NMR now as well to it. For you will not have for everything right now, but wherever it is reported, say this is in supporting information, so it has given that okay, this information is available in supporting. The NMR has been run at 400 megahertz in chloroform D for 1H NMR there, right? So you will have that information there directly. That is a huge data. So 13C also has been run. Then. If you have IR spectroscopy data, you have that information as well. And for every data points, you will have the actual reference as well. Again, right? So keep going. And for other data, you will have the use section. This compound is isolated from natural product as well. So you have the reference for the isolation of the natural product also. So 4-nitrobenzaldehyde is actually isolated. And then you have the chemical quantum calculations as well. For that particular compound. So a data for every related information for this. Now, if you want to know that on which target this particular compound is acting on, you have the information on the targets as well. So if you see here, for this particular protein, this is the most active compound, which is the 4-nitrobenzaldehyde. And if you want to know the actual data points, the inhibition assays, enzyme assays, you will actually see the actual data points as well, the experimental data point for that particular assay there. So you will find those informations for the targets as well. You can also toggle between the targets, documents, substances, reactions here itself, right? So this is what the information, again, I'm quickly showing few things as well. Let's show some interesting thing as well to you in like next 10-5 minutes. And we can have a separate session, a detailed session if you want to do that. Now we have, it has popped up. So if you see here, if you want to do a chemistry-based search, you have a chemistry-based forms. You can search based on identifying physical properties and so on. I'm not showing that because I'm talking to pharmaceutical. I will like to showcase what searches, various searches based on the properties you can run it. So if you are interested in target name, target action, substance effect, then route of administration, dosing regimen, substance highest clinical phase, bioassays, biosecretaries, bioassay name, then based on biological species, biological material name, clinical finding or disease. So you can search based on all these various parameters, organs, tissues, cell lines, cell fractions, then so on and so forth. Also, we have designed pre-designed forms. Say you are looking for a bioavailability or a toxicity forms. So you can search based on that. So you are looking for say bioavailability, see, right? So you click here on the bioavailability and automatically the parameters, the properties are filled up there and you keep filling what is your requirement based on that and you run a search there. So one can easily do that. You can work for selectivity of a compound between two targets. You can do that selectivity profile there. You click on that, you put the target, two target names, you put the PX values, what your desired activity might be, and then you can run the searches for that one. You can do volume of distribution, absorption, Kako2 permeability, active transport, SIPs, HUGs, blood-brain barrier penetrations. Then you have microsomal stability, protein binding, cardioxy. So each and every aspects of a particular compound, pharmacological data, actually you can run that. Somebody had raised the hand as well. We will come back to the question, sir. But you can type your question for the moment till I finish that. For the pharmacognosy, I will show you something interesting there. If you are interested in isolated and natural products there, you can search compounds based on isolated and natural products. And then you can actually say you want to search compounds or anti-cancer compounds, say, suppose, which are isolated from natural products. You can set one more parameter based on molecular formula or molecular weight as well. So you can add molecular formula or molecular weight. To it. say molecular formula, and then you say I will like to search compounds which are higher in molecular weight, say C30 and more. So C*star will it capture all the elements after C30, and you check what substances you are looking at it. I think something issue happened. Yes, you need to pay to use this particular tool, ReAccess. It's not freely available. Dr. Mahanta, let me know how much time I can take it. Or if you have any questions in the meantime, you can actually ask me as well.
Yes, Dr. Mandar, I have a question here.
Sure.
Like you showed for a lot of compounds where you have shown the number of steps for chemical synthesis, like okay. 7 steps, 8 steps.
Okay.
There is a compound known as eribulin mesylate.
Just a minute, I will type that.
Yes, eribulin mesylate.
What is the spelling?
E-R-I-R-I-B-U-L-I-N space mesylate. Now, this is a compound that has close to 60 steps of synthesis.
Okay.
Whether if you have such a tricky compound, whether such kind of steps can also be showed through ReAccess?
It will show. I think my network, I will just change my connection. I think something is happening there. I will just put a 4G there instead of the band. My connection is not supporting right now. Yes, it will show. ReAccess itself will show the route for that. This is a compound, right?
Yes.
I should have copied as well that compound. Okay, I will remove this. So it has shown it is active against 4 targets and the substances. So let's click on the substances. Let me connect, change my connection. So we have eribulin mesylate, and in ReAccess, because it's a known compound, we can have fine synthesis already, which are already based on again AI. You can have maximum 10 different plants. You can have linear and convergent synthesis with alternative branches of maximum 10. I will just putting all maximum things. And then if you select no here, it will go to a smallest possible commercial level starting material, and you can play with the average yield of a reaction as well. And because I am putting like higher numbers, it might, and the molecule is complex, it might take a little bit of time to come up with this route for this one. And again, suddenly I have seen my connection is getting poor, the broadband connection. So in the meantime, till it runs, I will just quickly show this ReAccess retrosynthesis also. So this is what the are you able to see that screen, right? Retrosynthesis, yes. Screen as well. Okay. So this tool is right now a separate in isolation, but it will get integrated by end of June, for second week of July, latest by second week of July. So you can actually draw a compound here as well. You draw a structure of a compound, and you can import as smiles or anything, or you can draw. And then, as I said, you can have maximum 20, you can have 100 plants, full synthesis plants. You can do a last step as well. You can increase or decrease the diversity of your synthesis plant, meaning that you, if you want that the predictions in multiple routes, that particular reaction does not have to occur in multiple routes, then you can select only one. So it will only occur once. And same with the building block also. You can actually have maximum 30 minutes of the processing time. The more the processing time, if it is a complex molecule, the more computer power required. So if you allow it more time, it might come up with a synthetic route. Then, as I said, we have building blocks options as well. So REACCESS common substrates, which are actually available from REACCESS. Then you have building blocks under $200 per gram, under $500 per gram, sigma, rich, e-molecules, tier one suppliers, means it will reach within 1 week of time to you, and lab network. So these are multiple options to run up there. And then if you just hit it, it will process that particular route. I will just go back and show you the known synthesis as well, just to in the flavor. Yeah, if you go back again to REACCESS, you see here it has shown you the synthesis of Arabilin mesylate, right? From every step, and for every step, you can click on it and you will have a conditions to showcase to you.
It is showing a 9-step preparation process.
No. I will show you whole thing. So every step you have procedure. So it is not just 9 steps. It might have, yeah, perfect. So it has a 9-step procedure here total, starting from here. Okay. And so then whether, yes.
Whether this method of synthesis is already patented by some company or.
So you have for every step you have references there. So yeah. It might be possible that the exact route is not published as the way it is published in the literature. Okay.
Okay.
So because it taps into all the journals, as I said, based on the artificial intelligence, it might create its own route, tapping the intermediates to come up with the synthesis also. Mm-hmm. But for every step, you will get the conditions on how you can run that particular condition. See, pressure secret. You have the procedure to run that. So same way the other routes are already present. Now you can also, I will go back to the quick search. You can copy this particular compound in the retrosynthesis also, and you can ask it to run in the retrosynthesis so that you have a very novel route, which is not at all published anytime. So if you say edit, I'll copy this structure into the retrosynthesis projects as well. And at that time, I will remove the mesylate there because if you have Arabilin itself, we can have the mesylate salt prepared for that Arabilin, right? So I will just draw that and let it run as well. So this is Arabilin. I'll run it for maximum time, allow it for that and let it run. So we'll see that if it comes up with the route or not, or we'll apply some other things to come up with a novel synthesis also. So I'll take you in the meantime, I will take you through the compound which I already run. So if you see here, I will show you how it looks like a synthesis plan. This is again a novel compound in JMC. It has appeared. I just ran it a couple of days back only. There is no synthesis reported apart from the JMC article right now. They are available. It's a novel compound itself. So if you see here, there are multiple routes published here. You can view it as a table view or tree view. So I will show you as a tree view first how it looks like in the retrosynthesis also. So this is how it looks like. The green boxes are the commercially available, and if you click on it, it will show you the sources, E molecules and under US $500 per gram. There. So here, E molecules, lab network, sigma aldrich, tier one suppliers, multiple suppliers, right? So you have the commercial availability, and this is also commercially available compound, right? So this is a REACCESS substrate as well. That's why it has shown RX, RX, and orange box as well. And you have, if you want to see the steps, you click on this one, show REACCESS example. It will show you how you can come up with that particular synthesis. Or you can go to the table view if you want to see in the reaction format. You can view that in the table view as well. If you see, this is the first step. I have already clicked on the REACCESS example. So this is actual. You want to do this alkylation on the amine, displacement of the chloro here. So if you see here, this is again pyrimidine chloro, same. And if you click on the REACCESS, it will take you to the that reaction with where you can find the experimental procedure or the reference to that particular article, where you can actually execute that particular reaction in the lab. If you see, there are six conditions there on how to execute that. You have experimental procedures, disopropane 1,4-dioxane with the procedure, right? So you have the actual article to run the procedure also, or the other articles where you have the conditions as well. If you want to look at the yields, you have this THF 50 degree for 12 hours where you can get 95% yield. So this is how the tool, the retrosynthesis tool works, where you get the link to the reaxes for the similar reactions plus the procedure. And you can just make this compound in two steps. This is commercially available. So you can just procure it and have your synthesis route prepared. Where in there, in that journal, it is actually a five-step procedure. It's captured in there, in that particular JMC article there. So you can make this compound in two step itself, which is the active compounds, and we can publish our own article. This is how it looks like. Quickly I have shown you, and let this molecule run. If by the time we end up, if it shows, I will come back to this also. Now, if you are looking at this miscellate, you have all the related example information regarding that as well, right? The bioactivities and everything. So you can, if you are looking at anything related to that, you have all those information in vitro activity in animal model data, toxicity data, and everything. I was showing you one thing before you asked the question, and I will come back. I will just quickly show that thing as well, which is isolated for pharmacognosy people, or later on I will for pharmaceutical and SLE people also. If you have time, we can stay back and I can show you that as well. We were looking at anti-cancer compound. Say anti-cancer. So you can do a complex searching here as well, and add the molecular formula. Say C, I was typing C30, right? C30 and more, and then find the substances. Now it will show you compounds which are isolated from natural products having anti-cancer activity with C30 or more molecular formula there. You can see how many out of 16,000 compounds are actually in the clinical phases. You can do the filter option. You can use the filters to filter it down. Say there are 20 market drugs out of this which are isolated from natural products and having anti-cancer activity. There are in preclinical 17 discontinued phase 1, phase 2, and so on and so forth. You can actually... if you are aware of the targets, you can actually filter them based on the targets, or you can directly run a heat map of all the 16,000 compounds against their targets. So it's like plotting a graph of a structure activity relationship. So you can plot the SAR, you can show the structures where targets to substances, and PX, as I said, the higher the PX number, the more the active compound is. Is it possible to study photolytic degradation reaction? Yes, it is. And reactions with catalyst by using this tool. Yes, Dr. Paramavati, yes, it is possible to study reactions with catalyst as well. And I can show you that. So if you see here, these are the compound and the compounds, and they're different. You might not be able to see the color coding here, actually, but there are all the target listed here and the compounds. Now, if you are working on, say, one particular target, if you are working or you are aware of this particular target and you are already working, you can sort that by activity so that the compounds get relisted there, where now the topmost compound will be the most active compound against the target of your choice there. And if you are willing to know about all the details of the compounds there directly, you can again go back to see the all substance detail related to that particular compound. And you will get the information on all the bioactivity hit data, bioactivity information there, physical portion. Or you, if you want to make this cultured compound also, like the Eribulin also. So you just create this plan. See here, you have these plans there, and every step you will have the reaction procedures. Directly after. Now there was a question that you can you search based on the catalyst there, reactions based on the catalyst. So yes, you can search there. So either you write catalyst name, if you are aware of it, and put on the reaction arrow so that you are searching reactions based on the Jacobson's catalyst, say, and transfer the query. Dr. Mahanta, they are asking the feedback link also, so you can provide them. If you have created any link, you can provide them the link as well, so that they will provide their feedbacks to you. So if you see, the Jacobson is used for the epoxidations, so you have the reactions based on that. Now if you want to use just a particular element instead of a particular catalyst there, you can say type ion. You want to study reactions of ion, say, can type there. Sorry, see, and say you want to maximize your searches there. Dr. Shailendra, you need to change it is the message is not going to everyone. I will just change that to all panelists and attendees. The feedback link will be sent to your respective emails. Okay, let's search the reaction now. Now these are all the reaction conditions, reactions using ion as a catalyst there. And if you now want to search a particular reaction, say CC bonding, CC bond forming reactions or anything, you can actually do that as well. So if you see, there is react product availability. So these are catalyst classes. So various catalysts, ion catalyst, if you are using it. So for active center heterogeneous catalyst organism, you can do that. Or if you want to search based on a particular reaction class, you can do that. So see here, go to view more. And if you see, there is CC bond forming reaction, substitution reaction, oxidation reaction. So if you as a student or as a teacher, if you want to actually study, let people know or make aware of it using a particular catalyst or a particular reaction, you can do that as well. See all those possible reactions with ion as a catalyst or a reagent is listed out here, right? So you can do that. Pushpa Gori Kapudi raised her hand. So Dr. Padmavati, I hope I have answered your question. Pushpa. So yes, Ms. Pushpa, can I have actually allowed you to talk? So you can unmute yourself and you can ask the question. Not able to hear you properly, ma'am. Can you type? I am not able to hear you properly. Can you type your question instead? Hello. Not able to hear you properly. Can you type your question, Miss Pushpa? Dr. Mahanta, we are already 1.5 hours in this meeting. Do you have any more questions at your end, or any other professors, Dr. Ahmed or Dr. Male?
I'll request the panelists who are there, if you are having any questions, you can share with Dr. Mandar.
I hope the presentation was useful.
Yes. The participants who want to ask your questions, you can put your questions in the chat box or the question answer session.
Data is available for herbal compounds?
Yes, you I will show you. Yes, it is available. So give a name of a compound, sir. You wish to see? You
Campo
want to see?
Tekan,
can you spell the
Campo
name?
Tekan.
Campo?
C-A-M-P-T-O.
P-T-O?
C-A-M. Campo Tekan. Antique expedient.
Campto?
Yes, sir. T-H-E.
Further? T-H-E?
Tekan. T-H-E-C-A-I-N.
C-A-I-N.
C-A-I-N.
Campo Theca is there. Yeah, it is Campo Theca is there. See, substances of Campo.
Yes. Anti-cancer.
Yeah. So, the Campo Theca is a herbal tree. You can say natural product. From there, these compounds are isolated.
Yes, sir.
Or if you just type the name of a compound in the structure also, let's do that. Campo Theca, C-A-I-N, you said?
Yes, Campo Theca.
No, is it the same, right name, sir?
Campo Theca.
Campo Theca, it is there. Campo Theca.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, see, Dr. Mahanda, we have got 5 different routes, okay, for erythrocin. So, new search. Draw the compound. Camptothecin is a known compound. My friend only had published articles in camptothecin as well. Dr. S.P. Chavan, Group Subhash Chavan in NCL, he was working on this molecule. I will edit that and remove the isotope salts mixture so that we have less hits. Yeah, so you have agamtothecin and you have all the data related to that, its reactions, preparations, targets, what camptothecin is acting against. Or if you want to plot that targets, again, all these 193 targets, you will have the data as I showed through the heat map as well, which are the most active targets in that particular region. So you can do that also at a time. So you will come to know at a time which are the most active, the camptothecin is active against which target actually, the most activity it has. Or you can filter it down to the PX and say PX maximum greater than 9. So that you have the most active data and then the targets will be automatically filtered. So it is DNA topoisomerase type 1. It is the most active against that camptothecin.
Yes.
Is it right, sir?
Yes, correct, sir. Right.
And then you actually can have all the data, as I said, bioactive data related to camptothecin. If you want to make this particular drug, you can just run this synthesis plan again. And let it run and I will come back. So if you see here, this is a commercially available compound. So that's why it is showing 1-2 step, but we can now run that particular synthesis of that particular as well. Tree view. If you see, because this tool is designed in a way that it ends up in a commercial level starting material. Now we can ask it to synthesize this one. Camptothecin. This is your synthesis of camptothecin also from a little bit cheaper starting material as well, right? You get the competition synthesis of camptothecin as well. So if you want to make that in the lab,
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Sir, like if we provide the data related to spectra and related to the properties, can we able to identify the structure of that by using this reaction software?
Okay, I will show you that. Query builder. So generally spectra, you cannot enter spectra, but if you have molecular weight, say you are knowing the mass of the compound, right? And if it is so I will show you how to do that. So you can say greater than equal to say 500. I will just type for example for you 001, and again I will add molecular weight and say less than or equal to 500.10. So this is again for pharmaceutical analysis also. If you are seeing an impurity, or if you are working in pharmacognosy, you are extracting a compound and you have a molecular weight of a compound, you are not aware of it, you can actually run the search and see in that small molecular weight range what are those compounds already available in the literature. It will not show you compounds which are not known in the literature for sure. So there are 2,951 compounds in that small molecular weight range. Okay. And you can view all this grid view directly. What are those compounds? So I've just shown you like quickly how you can do that. And then for every compound, you will have the data. So suppose you are looking at this particular compound data. Going back to list view is taking a little bit time. So if you want to know any compound data details, you can actually click on, say, physical data points. If you have spectral data points, you have, you will come to know if it is reported again, melting point is reported for this particular compound. So in your search also, you can add melting point parameter also. So go to query builder. If you have, say, now you can add melting point to add to your search, melting point. And now you can group this two also, because this is one combo search where within this molecular weight you have run, and then you add a melting point parameter. Now you say melting point is greater than or less than or equal to, out of this 2,900 compounds, 2,951, let's say it is less than or equal to 200. Suppose. And see if we can actually get anything. So from 2,951, we have 351 compounds where now the molecular weight range is 500.001 to 500.10 with melting point less than 200 degrees centigrade. And if you see the heat, because we have asked to search based on melting point, now it has shown you the heat data for every compound. You will see now the melting point here captured directly. So like this, you actually will be able to filter it out your compounds, right? From the physical properties of not the spectral data. You can add the physical data points, physical properties in your search, query builder search, create a complex search, and then you can come up with your search. So it can be utilized in pharmaceutical analysis, in pharmacognosy, to reach out to a possible structure.
Thank you very much, sir. So any other queries, please, Dr. Mahanta, sir?
No more queries.
Sir, I hope my talk was useful to you all, and hope it...
Yes, sir, it's very useful. And we have one session, that is a vote of thanks.
Sure, ma'am.
That will be delivered.
So then I will stop my sharing. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, madam.
I'll invite Mrs. R. Manjula, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Associate Professor, for deliver the word of thanks. Welcome,
yes, ma'am. Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Yes. Good evening, one and all. Myself, Ratna Manjula, Associate Professor from the Department of Phytochemistry, and Nirmala College of Pharmacy. I consider it's a great privilege to propose vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have witnessed it as a memorable and successful event. First of all, I would like to propose hearty thanks to our speaker, Dr. Mandas Bodas, research consultant, Reaxys, elsewhere, for making the webinar excellent and meaningful. I would like to express our profound gratitude to Provincial Superior Reverend Sister K. Maria Sundari Garu, Chief Patron of the webinar. Secretary and Correspondent of Nimlo College of Pharmacy, Reverend Sister T. Alfonso Garu, Patron of the today's webinar, for their continuous guidance and encouragement. It's my immense pleasure to convey my thanks to our beloved Principal, Dr. Abdul Rehman Garu, convener of the today's webinar, for his endless efforts to make the webinar successful. I would like to extend my thanks to Dr. Anjana Madam of Pharmaceutical Chemistry and Phytochemistry, co-convener of the webinar, and Dr. Sailendra Mahantasa, NIIC, President of NIIC, and also departmental staff for their support to make the webinar successful. Finally, I would like to thank all the delegates for their assimilation, learning attitude, and patience listening. Thank you, one and all.